And I thought that the best way to break the ice on version control systems and Git and some other related concept was to interview John Breeden, who works with GitHub. So let's go and see what John has to say about Git, about version control systems in general, and about GitHub. John is in Taipei, if I'm not wrong.
That's correct.
Okay, so we couldn't go there, so we're interviewing him remotely. And I just want to thank you so much, John, for agreeing to talk to us.
So thank you very much for having me. It was my pleasure.
And I'm just going to ask a few general questions to John, since he's an expert on Git and GitHub. And John is a developer and community builder, is active in both the open source and the open education areas. And as an education liaison at GitHub, he's working to improve computer science education by bringing the principles of open source into the classroom. And so I'm going to start with a very general question, which is, what is a version control system?
So a version control system is a tool that software developers use. You know, anybody who's doing working with digital assets, digital projects can also use for keeping track of revisions of your project. And when I say revisions, I mean essentially snapshots of your project over time. So you can imagine doing some work, and then every so often, be it every couple hours, every couple days, saving a permanent snapshot of your project.
Okay, so why is it useful? I mean, I understand the fact that it's nice to take a snapshot of your project, but what do you do with the snapshot afterwards?
So I think the most immediately obvious benefit to having snapshots of your project, to keeping revisions, is that you can go back. If you've ever worked on a project and gotten to a point where you've solved a bunch of your problems, and there's just one more step to do, and you start working on trying to solve that last step, and you break things. You make it worse than it was, an hour ago. At that point, it's easier to just go back to what you had than trying to figure out what you broke. So you can always go back in time. And then the other big one is being able to collaborate with multiple people. So it's pretty seldom these days that you work on a production totally on your own. It's most common to work in teams and small groups. So using a revision control system allows you to collaborate with other people and make sure that you don't step on each other's toes as you're working.
Yeah, that's great, because those are exactly some of the topics that we're going to cover in the lesson. And so since we're going to talk about the specific version control system, which is Git, and you're definitely an expert in Git, so what would you say is a specific, special about Git? What characterizes it, and how does it compare to other version control systems?
So if any of you have used version control systems before, you may have heard of something like Subversion, CVS, or maybe a commercial solution like Perforce. I think the main important characteristics of Git are first that it's open source, and the second that it's a distributed version control system. So what that means, a distributed version control system is essentially a system for tracking revisions of your software that doesn't have any central repository. So the biggest characteristic is that I can do my work and you can also work on the same project at the same time without communicating with each other and without communicating to a central system.
Okay, great. And so now that we saw what Git is, what is GitHub, and how does it fit into this picture of the distributed version control system?
So GitHub is the world's largest code host, and we essentially have a website where you can collaborate with people when you're writing code. There's two ways you can use GitHub. You can use it publicly for open source, and you can use it in private within your team or your company or within your class. And GitHub started out just as a way to host your Git repositories, but it's actually grown into quite a bit more. It's an entire collaboration system around your code.
How many users do you have?
I would say that we're approaching 5 million. I don't know the exact number. We're definitely more than 4 million right now. But yeah, I'd say somewhere close to between 4 and 5 million.
So that's a lot of space, I guess. Terabytes of disk space, I would imagine.
There are a lot of Git repositories on our servers.
Something else you want to say?
I guess that when talking about GitHub, there's one thing that you kind of can't leave out, and that's a feature that's called a pull request. So when you're using GitHub, you can share your Git repository, do some work, and actually do a code review of proposed changes, which is what we call a pull request on GitHub.com. So essentially what it lets you do is have a discussion about a set of proposed changes and leave feedback in line with the code. So you could say, for example, this method needs to be refactored, or I think I found an off by one error here, or different kinds of feedback, so that before you totally integrate some proposed changes, you have kind of a conversation about your code. And I think that's really valuable when you're working in a team.
Thank you, John. That was very informative. And thanks again for taking the time to talk to us.
No problem. Thanks for having me. I'll talk to you soon.
Let's thank again John for enlightening us on some aspects of version control systems, Git, and GitHub. And now let's go over some of the topics that we discussed with John to recap them.